In this lesson, we are going to understand about labor market. The topics that we will cover: what is labor market, demand for labor, supply of labor, and equilibrium in labor market. The term labor is used in business and economics to represent all those people who are willing to work and able to work, and they offer their services so that they can earn money, and we call it wages or salary. If they are getting money after a regular interval, we call it salary. But if they are working on hourly basis or part-time basis, we use the term wages. So wages is the price of labor or the reward for the time, working hours they are spending in any organizations. Labor market can be considered similar to the market of goods and services, as we have seen in the market equilibrium analysis, where both buyers and sellers of goods and services, they interact with each other and settle on the price of the product. Likewise, in the labor market, the product is labor itself or the working hour of the people. So two forces are the people who are supplying these working hours, we call it supply of labor, and people who are buying these working hours, and we call it demand for labor. So who demands for labor? It is the employer. These are the companies, the factories, the banks. So they need different people to work in their organizations. So in return, they give them money, which is wages or salaries. Likewise, the people who need money, so they have different skills, and they, based on their education and experience, they are selling their working hours. Better the skill, higher will be the reward. So far as demand for labor is concerned, demand for labor means the working hours which are demanded by the employer at certain wage level. The supply of labor is the working hour the labor is willing to sell at certain wage level. So far as the equilibrium in labor market is concerned, equilibrium point is the point where both buyers of the labor and sellers of the labor, they are agree to buy and sell at certain wage level. So the point where demand for labor is equal to supply of labor, that is called equilibrium point. Now let's see it in further detail.
For demand for labor, we use the symbol ND. For demand for labor, we use ND. And for supply of labor, NS. And here labor is one of the four factors of production. On the same lines, we can find out the prices for other three factors of production like land, capital, and enterprise. Both demand for labor and supply of labor, they depend on wages. W is the wages. So we use the symbol W as wages. This is real wage. There is another symbol we use in economics and business, that is capital W. Capital W stands for nominal wage. And there is a difference, and there is a relationship between nominal wage and real wage, that real wage times the price level is equal to the nominal wage. Nominal wage are the wages on the current price level. This is the monetary measurement. Whereas real wage is the focus is on the purchasing power of the money. For example, if one worker is getting $100, so this is the nominal wage, capital W. But how many goods and services he can buy? From these $100, that is called the real wages. So when we say demand for labor is a function of real wage, and supply of labor is also the function of real wage. And I have already explained that demand for labor is from employer, that is from employer. Who needs the labor, and supply of labor is from people themselves, the labor itself, who are willing to work and able to work. Here we can see the demand for labor curve. Demand for labor curve is similar to the demand curve of the goods and services. It has negative slope and it moves from left to right downward. So here this D stands for demand for labor. Demand for labor. Okay. So D dash, it is the demand for labor curve in this diagram. On the y-axis, we have the wages per hour. And here we have the ND, or the number of labor hours which are demanded by the employer. So when the wage level is 24, real wage is 24, 4 hours are demanded. When real wage is 23, if there is decrease in the real wage, 6 hours are demanded. So when wages decrease, demand for labor increases. Likewise, if there is increase in the wage level, if you move from 23 to 24 or from point D to point E, we find there is decrease in the demand for labor. So there exists an inverse or negative relationship between ND and wage level. So demand for labor is the function of a real wage, mean demand for labor depends on real wage. So whenever there is increase in real wage, less people will be demanded. And when there is decrease in real wage, more people are demanded for jobs. Or in other words, increase in real wage leads to decrease in demand for labor, and decrease in real wage leads to increase in demand for labor. And when two variables move in opposite direction, we call it negative slope. In this diagram, we can see the movement of the demand for labor curve. There are certain factors which shift the whole demand for labor curve towards right side or towards left side. For example, production. If there is increase in production, mean more goods and services are required in the country, then the more goods will be produced, so production will increase. So when there is increase in production, demand for labor curve will shift towards right. And when there is decrease in production, demand for labor curve will shift towards left. This is supply of labor curve, and here SS dash represent the supply of labor, where on X axis we have supply of labor and on Y axis we have wages. So like demand for labor, we have NS supply of labor, and supply of labor is depending on wages, or in the language of mathematics we can say supply of labor is the function of wage level. But here you notice there exists a positive relationship. For example, when wage level is 23, at this wage level there are 10 hours of labor which are offered by the labor, and they are willing to work for the 10 hours when the wage level is 23. If there is increase in wage level from 23 to 24, so people find themselves more comfortable to work on the higher salary, so they will increase their time from 10 hours to 12 hours. So in this way, the supply of labor will increase. And if there is decrease in the wage level, the supply of labor will also decrease from 12 to 10. So movement along this supply of labor curve from A to A, B, C, D, E, or from E point towards A, this movement is due to change in wage level. And there exists a direct or positive relationship, means if there is increase in wage level, supply of labor will also increase. And if there is decrease in wage level, supply of labor will also decrease. So this is called direct or positive relationship. In this diagram, we can see the shift in the supply of labor curve. And we can notice that supply curve is shifting towards right side or left side. This movement of supply of labor curve is not due to change in the wage level. Rather, it is due to the other factors like increase in population. If more people come in the country or in the market, supply of labor will increase. And if people leave the market or leave the country, the supply of labor will shift towards left. In this diagram, we can see the equilibrium in labor market. We have a demand for labor and supply of labor. Here on the x-axis, we have labor market. We have demand for labor and supply of labor, and on the y-axis we have real wages. We can find that when the wage level is 22, there is the agreement and equilibrium in the labor market, because demand for labor and supply of labor both are equal and they are 8. So 8 hours are demanded by the employer and 8 hours are offered by the labor. So both demand for labor and supply of labor, they are equal. So the condition for equilibrium in labor market is that demand for labor should be equal to supply of labor. And you have seen, when the wage level is 24 in the market, you can see here there's a gap between demand for labor and supply of labor. Supply of labor is more and demand for labor is less, because when the wages are higher, employer find it less viable to employ the more labor. So they decrease the employment, they decrease the demand. Whereas the employees, the people, or the supply of labor at higher wage level, so they increase their supply of labor. So supply of labor exceeds the demand for labor, In this case, we have the surplus in the labor market and the wage level will decrease. And we reach back to the equilibrium wage level. Likewise, if the wage level is 20 in the market, at this point you can see there is a shortage in the labor market. Demand for labor is 12 and supply of labor is 4. So demand for labor exceeds supply of labor. This is called shortage. Due to shortage in the market, the wages will increase and we will move back to the equilibrium wage level. So this equilibrium wage level is the stable point. Stable point means if there is any movement away from this equilibrium position, the forces in the market, the demand for labor and supply of labor, they will react or respond in such a way that they will push these wages back towards equilibrium wage level. So here the equilibrium wage level is 22, and at this equilibrium wage level, A is the demand for labor, so as the supply of labor. In this table, you can see the wages in this column and the labor demanded, number of hours of labor demanded in the second column. So when wage level is 20, demand for labor is 12. When it is 21, it is 10. At 22, it is 8, and so on. And same you can see in this diagram. So far as supply of labor is concerned, when the wage is 20, 4 hours are offered by the labor. The supply of labor is 4. When there is increase in wage level, there is increase in the supply of labor, and so on. So with the increase in wages, there is increase in supply of labor, and with the decrease in wages, if you see bottom up, there is decrease in the supply of labor. So, and this is shown with the help of this diagram. At equilibrium, in the first column we have wage level, in the second we have demand for labor, and in the third we have supply of labor. So when wages are 20, demand for labor is 12 and supply of labor is 4. There is shortage in the market, and due to this shortage, the wages will increase and it will go to 21. At this wage level, demand for labor is 10 and supply of labor is 6. Because increase in wage level is not the good news for the employer. Rather, it is considered a good news for the labor itself. So they increase the working hours. So here still there is a gap between demand for labor and supply of labor. So demand for labor is more than supply of labor. There is still shortage and wage level will increase. And here we notice that demand for labor and supply of labor both are same. And same is shown at this point. When wage level is 22, there is an equilibrium in the labor market. Likewise, if the wages are higher, let's say 23 or 24, there is a surplus in the labor market because more people are willing to work and less people are demanded. There is a less job in the market. So there is a surplus, and surplus always decrease wages. So this is called the equilibrium point. Equilibrium point means the point where demand for labor is equal to supply of labor. Okay, so in this lesson we have learned what is labor market, what is labor market, the concept of demand for labor, supply of labor, and equilibrium in labor market. As a quick revision, labor means the people who are willing to work and able to work, and they are offering their working hours to earn the money, and this money is either wages or salary. So far as the labor market is concerned, labor market is the place where both the sellers of the labor and the buyers of the labor, they interact with each other and settle down the wage level. Labor market is similar to the market of goods and services. The only difference is instead of goods and services, now we have the labor which is being bought and sold. Demand for labor means the people or the working hour which is demanded by the employer, and it depends on the wage level. supply of labor mean the people itself, the labor itself, who is offering their time for work. Equilibrium in labor market is the point where the demand for labor is equal to supply of labor, and at this point the market equilibrium wage level is determined. We have also seen the difference between the real wage and nominal wage. The nominal wage is the money that labor is earning, and how much goods and services the labor can buy from the money they have earned, that is called the real wage. So if we multiply real wage with price level, we get the nominal wages. That's all in this lesson. Thank you very much.